Hey everyone, hopefully you're having a good day. My name's Andy, my channel's Finding Value. Today I wanted to go over uranium and touch on something. I wanted to see how the price sensitivity to movements in uranium, how that affects the actual end user price of electricity. And I was doing some research just to see what the cost is of the raw material in its direct, you know, that impact to the final end user and the cost of electricity to an end user. And I'm going to throw some uranium kind of price numbers and what the impact of that uranium price going up to has on the final electricity cost to the end user. And it's a very short clip. It's nothing too complex, but I'll get into it here. So here we go. This is the uranium cost, and it's just this one slide. The cost, so I'm going to read down here. The cost of raw uranium contributes about $0.0015 per kilowatt hour to the cost of nuclear electricity, while in breeder reactors, the uranium cost falls to $0.00015 kilowatt hours. So basically, in a breeder reactor, you could go up many, many, many fold in uranium price with absolutely zero impact to the cost of electricity. So the cost of raw uranium in a nuclear electricity using this number here. So just to give you guys some background, the contract average, from what I understand, is about $35 per pound of uranium. That is what the current contracts are pricing is under. The cost of raw uranium is 0.0015, and that's its contribution to the cost of electricity right now. So if the average cost of uranium is $35 a pound, and the cost of uranium is 0.0015, so if this is to this, then if we raise it, if we were to raise the end user's cost by 2 cents per kilowatt hour, which would be dramatic, or maybe not, but it's 2 cents per kilowatt hour, uranium price would have to go, would go to $466 per pound if we wanted to contribute, you know, attribute that price move of uranium to the final cost. So a 2 cent move in the final cost of electricity is equivalent to a 466 pound move in uranium, dollars per pound. So it went from 35 to 466. To raise it 1 penny per kilowatt hour, it would be $233 per pound at the 1 cent kilowatt hour raise. So what I'm trying to do here is I'm trying to figure out what is the sensitivity of the electricity price versus the input cost of uranium. So you in lean, you look at like a SIPOC. It's supplier, input, process, output, customer. And what we're looking at here is the process and what the input costs and what the effects of the output costs are. So our input costs, it is right now, you could go to $233 a pound of uranium, and the impact to the end user is a penny increase in electricity cost. Now, we could see a very large inflationary period where, if we had just massive inflation, that when you cost adjust it, you could go to $233 a pound and really stay at the same uranium ratio. So this is an increase above and beyond what the we'll call it the inflation adjusted price, which is the gold price. So if gold goes like a bat out of like a bat out of heck, and the price with the inflation in it goes ramping higher, then you got the supply demand, you know, balance that's going back and forth. That's the ratio against gold. So we could see prices that are much higher than this even, but it would be a huge inflation component in it. So I don't know exactly where the price is going to go. I don't want to pretend like I do. But that's the sensitivity of the price moves to the end user. And I think we're going to move a lot higher than the last bull market if we get the inflation that I think we might get. And it may take some time, too. This may not happen in a year. It may not happen in 2 years. It may happen in a couple of years. Maybe it does. I don't know. That's why I buy this stuff and hold on. I'm not in the game of trying to speculate on the exact timing. I think it's almost impossible to get the timing right and the price right. So I'm just going to let the charts do the talking. I'll let the valuations and ratios tell me when we're cheap and when we're expensive, and we're cheap right now. And I'm going to continue to overlap technical analysis and value with each other. And that's how I'm going to roll this bull market. And hopefully this gives you some entertainment and some valuable information here. If you guys like this content, give me a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And thanks for listening. This is Finding Value.